Welcome to our city tour through the center of the historical heart of Berlin. I am Jana Klee of the agency Panorama-b, and I'd like to present to you some of the main aspects of the 800-year-old history of the city in reference to selected sites. We are now in the Nikolai Quarter and are looking towards Propststraße, right beside the Nikolai Church. This is where the origins of the town lie. History tells us that Berlin was founded by merchants in the late 12th century. The church was dedicated to St. Nicholas, the patron of merchants in medieval times. But Berlin developed alongside a second town named Köln. Both lay along a ford on the river Spree, Köln on an island, and to its east, Berlin on the mainland. Over the course of time, the two communities grew into a prospering twin town with additional suburbs. Since the 18th century, the whole city has been called Berlin. Around 1230, the Nikolai Church took shape, first as a basilica built in the form of a fortress. You can see it here clearly, the massive and monumental westwork with its ashlar masonry made of fieldstones dominates the churchyard up until today. In the years leading up to 1490, St. Nikolai was transformed into a Gothic hall church. Since then, it has been one of the many examples of the flourishing brick architecture in this region. The two twin towers so prominently emerging from the Berlin skyline were added only in the 19th century. In 1938, the church was deconsecrated, and now an exhibition about its history is being shown in its rooms. Like many parts of the Berlin city centre, the Nikolai Quarter was hit heavily in the Second World War, as the following historical photos demonstrate. Many of the houses in the narrow streets were reduced to rubble. The church itself was a poor sight. After having removed the debris, the quarter belonging to East Berlin remained as wasteland, with only the ruin of the church and some of the houses still standing. Not until the 750th anniversary of the city in 1987 did the East German government rebuild the quarter as a great prestige project. From 1979 onwards, a quite free and fragmentary reproduction of the old Berlin was developed under the supervision of the architect Günter Stahn. If you take a look around here, you can see hard contrasts between rows of houses in their historical appearance and prefabricated concrete buildings, which try to simulate an ancient ambiance by showing arcades and stepped gables. The aim was clearly not to achieve an historically correct reconstruction, but to create a setting for experiencing former times. Thus, it can be explained why houses were reconstructed here which never actually stood in the Nikolai Quarter. One example is the restaurant Zum Nussbaum, which was originally located in Berlin's twin town, Köln. It had been the local tavern of the famous Berlin illustrator Heinrich Ziller. As he focused his sketches on the working class and the poor, this place was important to the identity of the German Democratic Republic that defined itself as the state of workers and farmers. Due to the lack of historical authenticity, the Nikolai Quarter received the nickname the Disneyland of Erich Honecker, who was the head of state at the time. Nevertheless, the reconstruction of the quarter demonstrates a remarkable effort to revive a piece of the city's history. This could not be taken for granted. In other places, the East German authorities showed quite a brutal attitude towards the historical heritage, as with the old Köln, which was not reconstructed after 1945, but had to make room for a tower block complex. But let us now leave the origins of the city and take a walk to the banks of the river Spree, where in the 15th century a new era in the city's development began. Ready for more discoveries in Berlin? The Panorama-b app combines multimedia walking tours with a classic city guide, giving you an exciting and informative way to explore the city offline. Just download it now.